Hello and welcome. You are watching the Cellframe News Blog, and today our topics are progress towards the launch of the two-way bridge, web development, the team has been working in stealth mode and the results will soon be visible to everyone, Cellframe dashboard and Cellframe wallet updates. Let's find out what our teams accomplished in the last 2 weeks, how things are going with the Calvipiam team, and as usual we'll end with some interesting news from the marketing team. We start with the two-way bridge mode. This is the topic with the greatest number of your questions. Of course, this work is crucial for cell holders, validators, and for the team. The first important factor is the work being on the new node version. We managed to implement most of the steps needed to prepare for the release of node version 5.3. The node, as you understand, is very important for the bridge. We also added node command outputs in the JSON RPC format. There is one nuance in the transition to the new node that I want to draw your attention to. We are now much closer to the release of node 5.3 and its new synchronization architecture. Once the release occurs, keep in mind that nodes running the new version will still be able to exchange messages with nodes that haven't yet updated. But validator master nodes will not receive rewards for validating transactions until they are updated to the new version. Conclusion: don't delay updating. Moving on, there is now a new implementation of the handler using the JSON RPC protocol. We have instituted the new protocol for node commands when working with the ledger. This greatly simplifies the development of applications that work with the node as their engine, such as dashboard and Cellframe wallet. It will also simplify the further development of any other add-ons to the node, both for our development teams and for external developers. Next, we will continue developing a handler for commands when working with the DEX and with orders. In addition, the team has made corrections to our master branch, which is now available to users. The impact of the corrections concludes increased stability of the node, movement of emissions through the network, and displaying transactions history in Cellframe networks after community voting events. And now it's time to shed some light on the stealth development from the web team. As it turns out, the team was secretly working on a redesign of the main Cellframe website. The guys developed new visuals for the site, which correspond to the latest technology design trends. The first version of the site redesign will soon be available via the same link, Cellframe.net. If you like the new site design, be sure to write to us in the feedback form or in the main project chat, and we will make sure to pass the feedback on to the team members. They will be happy to hear from you. Along the way, the team found and eliminated the cause of the error due to which bridge transactions were temporarily not running, and restored the operation of the bridge to Cellframe's native networks. Let's move on to news from Cellframe dashboard and Cellframe wallet projects. The Cellframe dashboard team continues to work on improving the DEX tab. Cellframe DEX is already available through the console, but now the team is working on a graphical interface so that our exchange can also be used by people without programming experience. The release of the DEX in Cellframe dashboard will allow CF20 token holders on the Backbone and CalVPN networks to exchange tokens. For example, if you have a cell token and want to run a masternode on the CalVPN network, then you can exchange cell tokens for Cal on the Backbone or CalVPN networks. Over the past 2 weeks, we have made good progress towards the release of this very complex functionality. The foundation of it was built early, and now we were mainly focused on fixing bugs and finding shortcomings. The team has already implemented multi-threaded graphics processing to make the display fast and comfortable for different platforms, especially for macOS. In the current period, we have fixed crashes, interface slowdowns, as well as excessive CPU load during multi-threaded graphics processing, which made it possible to start using the new implementation. The team also recently refactored the order creating form, allowing for more efficient DEX development and for making corrections. Visual bugs such as empty fields in order information, display of current rates of trading pairs, and the order book display have also been fixed. now these functions work correctly. Next to news about CellFrame Wallet, the wallet application created especially for mobile platforms. The front-end team is unfreezing the development of CellFrame Wallet for Android. On the back-end, porting the wallet to the new platform is already in full swing. Here's what has been done already. We restored the functionality of the application. Namely, we improved and adapted the latest developments from CellFrame dashboard and updated the backend. The main code for the application is fully working and is now ready for further debugging. We also added an accounting for fees when sending transactions. This was required to handle connection of third-party validators to the Backbone and Calvipan networks. Now let's look at news from the Calvipan team. There were some pleasant surprises here too. You've all heard more than once about the team's plans to support iOS, and we are all waiting for this, of course. But there was no exact forecast for the release time. And suddenly it turned out that work on porting the application is already underway. Despite the fact that the team still has a lot to do before the actual release of the Calvipan app on iOS, they have already managed to successfully launch the backend of the application on the iOS platform. I congratulate the team, this is great news for all of us. The Calvipan team also continues to work on the collaboration mode with CellFrame dashboard. We recently released a new build to our internal testers and to the whole beta community and received new feedback. Some of the problems and shortcomings they identified for collaborative mode have already been corrected. The logic of interaction between Calvipan and CellFrame dashboard has been improved. Now the continue button will not work if there are errors in connecting Calvipan to CellFrame dashboard via Web3 API. Thus, if for some reason the connection doesn't work, the user will understand this even before attempting to connect, since the button will be inactive. The transaction history was also being debugged and now displays correctly. There are also some notable improvements in the Calvipan website. The team adjusted the changing font size when switching orientation to landscape and back. Now the font size matches the font orientation. And now all I have left to do is tell you about how these 2 weeks went for our marketing and PR teams. Preparations for the Blockchain Live 2024 conference in Dubai are in full swing. Let me remind you that in April, we will be glad to see you at our booth on the world's coolest forum on blockchain and cryptocurrencies. It's easy to find us on the Blockchain Live site. Check out the map and booth design. Moving on. Dmitry Gerasimov recently conducted one of our traditional AMA sessions, where he answered questions collected in advance as well as those you sent during the stream. As always, these streams are lively and full of fire. Partner AMA sessions with crypto communities are also taking place as usual. Stay tuned for announcements. Well, we can all feel that spring is ahead and a lot of interesting things are coming. See you next time!